Till now, what we have talked about, I'll give you a quick revision of whatever we had covered in the last class. I'll give you a quick revision. Okay, so what we're talking about is, भाई इफ आई हैव अ इन्वेस्टमेंट अपॉर्चुनिटी, ओके, एंड द आउटफ्लो इन दैट इन्वेस्टमेंट अपॉर्चुनिटी इज इक्वल टू 1 लाख, ओके, एंड द रिटर्न ऑफ द इन्वेस्टमेंट, एंड द रिटर्न ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट इज गोइंग टू बी ओवर द कोर्स ऑफ 4 years, 1, 2, 3, 4. इन द फर्स्ट ईयर वी विल गेट 20,000, इन द सेकेंड ईयर वी विल गेट 30,000, इन द फोर्थ ईयर विल गेट 40,000, एंड इन द फिफ्थ ईयर विल गेट 30,000 अगेन. ओके, सो नाउ यू हैव, व्हाट यू हैव टू डू इज यू हैव टू जज, सिंस यू आर द फाइनेंस मैनेजर ऑफ द कंपनी, यू हैव टू बी द जज एंड यू हैव टू डिसाइड whether the company should accept this proposal or not. Okay, you have to decide ki bhai this is going to be beneficial for the company or is this not going to be beneficial for the company. This is what you have to decide. Okay, and for that we have some techniques that we will study to assess an investment option. Aapke paas koi bhi option hai to usko assess karne ke liye there are some techniques that we will study in this chapter. Okay. So the first thing that we will study today is how are you going to assess? By some layman who doesn't know financial management, he's going to say ki okay, outflow is 1 lakh and inflow is, let's add all the 60 60 120, so you are having a profit, so it's fine, you should accept the proposal. But being a student of financial management, we know that the value of money does not remain the same. What this means is if you will receive some money after 4 years, then the value of this money, 30,000, is not going to be 30,000. Of course, the amount is going to be 30,000, but the value is not going to be 30,000. The value is going to be something less than 30,000, right? Applying the principle of time value of money. The principle states that the value of money is dependent upon time. Okay, money that is received today is more valuable than the money that is receivable after some time. Okay, so what we'll compare is, we'll compare the outflow of 1 lakh with not this inflow, but we will calculate the present value of inflow. Right, this is the inflow in absolute terms, but we will calculate the present value. What is the meaning of present value? This means that if the money, if this 20,000 will be receivable today, then what would be the value of the total inflow? Okay, so we'll make a chart. We'll write years 1, 2, 3, and 4. We will calculate discounting factor. We'll calculate discounting factor for, let's say, our rate in the question is 12%. Let's say 12%. So how we'll calculate discounting factor? I've already told you. 1 upon 1 plus r raised to the power n. N is number of years. N is number of years. So the first year, for the first year, it's going to be 1 upon 1.12. For the second year, it's going to be 1 upon 1.12 raised to the power 2. For the third year, 1 upon 1.12 raised to the power 3. And 1 upon 1.12 raised to the power 4. How are we going to calculate this? Discounting factor. I'm going to open calculator. And in this calculator, I'm going to write 1 divided by 1.12. This gives me 0.8923. Ab dekhiye. I'm going to write this as 0.893 because 8, because I'm going to round it off. This is going to be 0.8893. Okay, then I just have to press equal to. I don't have to write everything again. I have to press equal to. This is 0.797. 0.797. Okay. 0.97. Then I'll again press equal to. This is going to be 0.7. Point 712, and for the last it is going to be 0.635. Okay, now I'll write what is my inflow. Inflow will be given to you in the question. It is 20,000, 30,000, 40,000. And 30,000. Now I'll multiply and calculate the present value. I'll calculate the present value. Okay, if this 20,000 is receivable after 1 year, then what will be the present value of 20,000? If this 20,000 would be receivable today, then what would be the value of this 20,000? So I'm just going to multiply 20,000 multiplied by 0.893. That is equal to 17,860. Then 30,000 into 0.797 equals to 23,910. 40,000 into 0.712 equals to 28,480. And 30,000 into 0.635 equals to 19,050. And if I add all this, it comes out to be 89,300. Are you getting what is happening? The present value of my cash outflow. Present value of cash outflow is 1 lakh versus present value of cash inflow is 89,300. So do you think I should accept the proposal? My question to you is, accept or reject, what should we do? Accept the proposal or reject the proposal? What do you guys think we should do? So we are going to reject the proposal. This amount is very less as compared to what we are putting in the business right now. Okay, guys, I hope it is clear. And this technique is called net present value. This technique is called net present value method. Okay, now for the purpose of this was just an example for me to help make you understand how we are going to apply the principle of time value of money and how everything is going to take place. Now I'm actually going to start using those capital budgeting techniques. Okay, so I'll just make a diagram sort of thing. Just please pay attention. So when we talk about capital budgeting techniques, okay, there are basically two type of capital budgeting techniques. One is discounting technique, another one is traditional. In traditional technique, we talk about two basic techniques of capital budgeting. First is payback period. And the second one is ARR, that is accounting rate of return. On the other hand, when I talk about discounting, the techniques that I'm going to study are discounted payback period, second is net present value method, fourth is sorry third third for third one we have profitability index. And for fourth, we have internal rate of return or IRR. Okay, these are the six techniques that we are going to study. First of all, we are going to start with the traditional technique. The first technique that we are going to study is payback period, and the second technique that we are going to study is ARR. After that, we are going to move on to the discounting cash flow techniques. What is the difference between the both of the techniques? In this techniques, the concept of time value of money is ignored. Traditional, it is very traditional, right? The concept of time value of money is ignored. And that is why these techniques are not very good. They are not used that frequently by making the decision. These techniques are better as compared to traditional techniques. So the first thing that I'm going to talk about in today's class is payback period. It is payback period. Okay, and see how I'm going to teach this topic is I'm going to ask you guys to think, and please think, and you can all, I'll just, you know, like, yes, I have the chat box open with me. If you guys want to respond on the chat box, you can definitely respond on the chat box. There's no problem. Okay, I have the chat box open with me right over here. And okay, so I have the chat box. If you guys want to ask anything, if you guys want to say anything, then I have the chat box with me. Okay, no problem. So payback period. See, I'll give you an example. I have two options, option A and option B. Okay, in option A, I'm talking about option A. What is the cash outflow? Is 1 lakh. In option B also, my cash outflow is 1 lakh. What is the meaning of cash outflow? If you have to make that investment, if you have to purchase that investment, if you have to purchase that machinery, so first of all, you will have to make some cash outflow. There's going to be some cash outflow, and it in return you are going to get that investment. So to purchase that investment, you have to make some, you have to expend some cash. That is cash outflow. And the cash inflow schedule is given to you. Cash inflow schedule is given to you. Okay, cash inflow year one, year two, year three, year four. Okay, so for project A, the cash inflow schedule is somewhat like this. Then I'm going to ask you guys to think what should be the right answer. Then I'm going to tell you the right answer, and most probably I'm assuming that all of you would be right, because we know everything. All these things you already know. I'm just giving you how to technically apply these things to a given practical situation and how to draw conclusions out of it. That is what I'm teaching. This is basic common sense. You all know everything. Okay, so cash inflow schedule is something like this. First 10,000, second 20,000, then 40, then 50. Okay, and for project B, it is going to be like, well, let's spice it up a little bit. This is 20, okay, and this is 30. Let me just make a few changes in the question. The total inflow is Okay. So these are the two options that is given to you. Okay. Which option will you select? The total inflow of both the projects is equal. It is exactly the same, 160 and 160. But there's some difference, right? In option A, you are receiving the funds in this sequence. And in option B, this is how you are receiving the funds. So if I ask you, which project are you going to select? My question is, which project are you going to select?
Option A.
A or B? So how are you going to, what answer are you going to give me? What are you thinking? What do you think it should happen? Which project should you select? Very easy. So for this, we will apply the concept of payback period. It states that what is the time in which we recover the amount invested in the business. Okay, payback period means what is the time in which we recover the amount we have invested in the business, for example, or in the project, not business, in the project. So if I talk about option A and option B, in option A, you can see that we have to recover this amount. We have to recover this amount. And for option A, this is going to take how many years? Somewhere here. We are going to recover the amount over here. And if we talk about option B, we are going to recover the amount in over here. So in option B, the payback period is approximate. Let's say approximate 2 years. And for option A, the payback period is 3 years. Right? You can see, right? 30 plus 40, 70, 70 and 40, 110. So somewhere over here, we are going to recover the amount that we have invested. And when we talk about project B, 1 lakh rupees, we are going to recover in 80 and 1.5 years only. Not even two, it's 1.5 to be precise. And I'll tell you how to calculate. There's a formula, there's everything. So don't worry about that. But what I'm trying to explain is, do you understand the basic concept? Do you understand the outline, the structure of what is happening? That is my focus right now. That is what I want to explain right now. Okay, I'll tell you the formulas and examples and everything. So the difference is in this. Okay, if you talk about this point. So in project A, we are recovering the amount in 3 years. And in project B, we are recovering the amount in 1.5 years. So which project do you think we should choose? So I think we should go with project B. We should go with project B is the better option because I'm recovering my amount earlier than project A. So we are going to select project B and we are going to go ahead with project B. This is called payback period. This is called payback period. I hope it is clear to everyone. I hope this point is clear to everyone. If it is not, I'll just look at the chat box right now. You can send your messages on chat. Yes. ठीक है, इट इज क्लियर, राइट? प्रोजेक्ट ए जो है, यहाँ पे हमको अपना पैसा जो हमने लगाया था उसको रिकवर करने में 3 साल का वक्त लगेगा, लेकिन प्रोजेक्ट बी में ये काम 1.5 साल में हो जाएगा। तो जब हमने जो पैसा लगाया था वो हमको जल्दी वापस मिल रहा है, तो हम दोनों में से उस वाले प्रोजेक्ट को चूज करेंगे जिसमें पैसा हमको जल्दी वापस मिल रहा है। इट मेक सेंस, ऐसे सब लोग ऐसे ही करते हैं ना, पर लोग कोई गलत बात नहीं बता रहा मैं, ऐसे होता है सब जगह, ठीक है ना, कि भाई जितना जल्दी हमारा पैसा रिकवर हो जाएगा वो अच्छी बात है, उसके बाद हमको प्रॉफिट होना शुरू हो जाएगा, सही बात है ना? तो इट इज गुड, जितना जल्दी पैसा मिल जाए आपको वापस उतना रिस्क कम होता है, आपने अपना अमाउंट रिकवर कर लिया, देयर इज लेस रिस्क, सो हमेशा हम इसको प्रेफर करते हैं। ओके, आई होप इट इज क्लियर टू एवरीवन नाउ। चलिए, नाउ आई विल मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट कंसेप्ट दैट आई वांट टू टीच यू गाइस। Okay, so this payback period, okay, this payback period, it can be calculated in two ways. First, for projects. With equal cash inflow. And second, projects with unequal cash inflow. Okay, equal cash inflow, unequal cash inflow. What is the meaning of equal cash inflow? So equal cash inflow means, that every year you are getting the same amount every year. For example, if you invest in project A, okay, your outflow is 1 lakh and your inflow is 20,000 per year. It is 20,000 per year. And if I calculate what is the payback period, if I ask you what is the payback period, what are you going to do? You're going to divide this amount by, we have invested 1 lakh rupees. Okay. And we are getting 20,000 per year. So it is going to take 5 years for me to recover my investment. It is going to take 5 years for me to recover my investment. So the payback period is 5 years. Just let me know if there is any problem in understanding this. It is clear, right? Okay. So for equal cash inflows, the formula is payback period is equal to total cash outflow upon cash inflow per year. This is the formula. See, and I'm not just telling you the formula. The difference in, you know, what I want to teach is, how I want to teach is, I don't want to throw information at you. Okay, I don't want to tell you ki bhai, if this is happening, apply this principle. If this is happening, apply this concept. Main aise nahi padhana chahta aap logo ko. And I want to teach you ki bhai, why this is happening. But this is what my role over here is. And we have sufficient time. There's no rush. Okay, we have sufficient time. So I want to explain by why this is happening. It is a very basic, first, you know, very primary method of evaluation of any investment opportunity. Ki bhai, whatever I am investing, after what time or how much time is it going to take for me to recover my investment? That is a very basic thing. And everybody is going to think about that. Okay, it makes sense, right? So there can be two options. Either the cash flow is equal or cash flow is unequal. In case of equal cash flow, it's very easy. You can just divide the total investment that you're making, divide by the cash inflow, and you will get 5 years. And if there are two products, let's say product B, an outflow for product B is 2 lakh. Okay. And cash inflow is 50,000 per year. So the payback period is 2 lakh divided by 50. That is 4 years. So if we compare to the two products on the basis of payback period, then product A has a payback period of 5 years and product B has a payback period of 4 years. So which product do you think we should accept? Like, we are going to go with project B. We are going to go with project B because the time is less. Although the amount is more, but it is okay. We are going to recover the amount sooner as compared to that A. I hope that is clear to everyone. Huh? There's no problems. Yes, sir. Okay. Now moving on to unequal cash flow. This is the example. The example we took now. This is unequal cash flow. Can you see? First year 30, 40, 50, 40, 50, 80, 40, 30, 10. This is unequal. You know, this is visible, right? It is unequal. So what is the formula in this situation? It is very basic, but very easy. So payback period is equal to number of years whole plus cash flow required upon cash flow for the year. Okay, what is the formula? Payback period is equal to number of years whole in whole numbers plus cash flow we require and cash flow for the year. For example, I'll calculate the payback period of these two these two, project A and project B. Exact. Abhi toh this was just approximation. Now I will calculate the exact amount of payback period so that it is clear to you. Okay, so I am calculating the payback period for project A. Okay, so how do we calculate? First, we calculate cumulative cash inflow. Like cumulative frequency, if you've heard of it, we calculate cumulative cash inflows for project A and cumulative cash inflows for project B. This was 1 lakh, okay? Cash inflow, I'm talking about cash inflow, not outflow, outflow separate. Inflow. So for the first year, the inflow is 30,000. For the second year, I'm going to add this. It is 70. For the next year, it is 110. And for the next year, it is 160. Similarly, I'll calculate cumulative cash inflows for project B. Okay. For the first year, it is 80. For the second year, it is 120. I'll add, okay, then 150 and then 160. Okay, clear to everyone? Any problem up to this point? No sir, no problem. Now see, in project A, what is the amount that I want to recover? So I want to recover 1 lakh rupees, right? I want to recover 1 lakh rupees. So 1 lakh rupees is somewhere over here. But at the end of third year, I would have earned 1 lakh 10,000. So 1 lakh rupees I would have earned somewhere over here. Are you getting what I'm saying? But at the end of third year, your total income from the project is 110. Okay, what is the amount that you want to recover? Well, it was 1 lakh rupees. So 1 lakh rupees you would have recovered somewhere over here. Okay, so I apply this in the formula. Payback period is equal to time in whole numbers plus cash flow required upon cash flow of the year. So whole number, year one, year two. So 2 years I'll need, plus I will need, so for the 2 years I have recovered 70. For the 2 years I recovered 70. How much do I need? I need 30. And how much do I have? I have 40. Okay. So what is this trying to tell us is ki bhai total 70,000 to maine cover kar liya 2 saal ke end tak. Second year ka end aate aate maine jo hai apne paas recover kar liya. Kya recover kar liya maine apne paas? Maine recover kar liya this 70,000. Mujhe kitna recover karna hai? Mujhe recover karna hai 1 lakh rupees. So 2 saal to lagenge 70,000 rupees kamane mein. 2 saal to maine aise aise likh diye. Plus ab aapne 70 kamane liye kitne aur kamane hain aapko? Aapko kamane hain 30,000. आपको कितना कमाना है? 30,000. और आपके उस साल की पूरी जो इनफ्लो वो कितनी है? 40. ठीक है, इसको मैं डिवाइड कर देता हूं 3/4. 3/4 दिस 0.75. सो इट्स गोना टेक 2.75 इयर्स फॉर यू टू रिकवर योर इनिशियल इन्वेस्टमेंट इन केस ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट ए. इन केस ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट ए तो आई राइट 2.75 इयर्स फॉर project A. Okay, I hope it is clear. Now if I move on to project B, same thing I'll apply for project B as well. So for project B, I have to recover 1 lakh rupees and I'm getting 120 at the end of 2 years. So this means that somewhere over here, okay, approximate somewhere over here, I would have recovered my total amount that I've invested. So whole time in whole year, that is 1 year. By for the my earning of 1 year is 80,000. So 1 year plus how much do I need? I need 20,000 more, and that is divided by how much I am earning in the second year. I am making 40,000. So this is going to be 1.5 years. Okay, so for project A, my payback period or the amount or the time that it will take to recover my investment, to regain my investment, okay, that is 2.75 years. And if we talk about project B, that amount is only 1.5 years. So which do you think are you going to accept if you are the businessman? Of course, everyone is going to go for project B because the time is less. And we want to recover the amount as soon as possible. Is it clear? Is it clear to everyone? I'm just looking at the chat right now. If you guys have any problems, then please do ask me now. Okay, clear. So I'll just give you a quick revision and then we'll talk about the second method of that is AR, accounting rate of return. We're going to talk about this method right now. Okay, and if I show you the study material that I've prepared for you, then you can also see. This is the study material that I've uploaded on your Moodle and you can have a look and you know, this is what we are studying. But this is just for the topic of capital budgeting. Okay, this is not a complete, I'm not uploading a complete PDF because nobody studies those PDF, right? There's no point in uploading. But here, capital budgeting techniques. So capital budgeting techniques that we are following over here are traditional techniques or non-discounting and discounted cash flow techniques. So for traditional techniques, we're going to talk about two techniques, payback period and accounting rate of return. And this study module is of ICAI, you know, so we are studying of that level and, you know, it is very good. There's nothing we are leaving behind. Everything is covered. If you talk about time adjusted, then we'll talk about net present value. We'll talk about profitability index. We'll talk about IRR and discounted payback. Modified IRR, we don't have to cover as much. You know, that is not covered in the syllabus of BBA. So we can skip this. Everything else we are going to cover in the class. So payback period. The payback period of an investment is the length of time required for the cumulative total net cash flows from the investment to equal to the total initial cash outlays. And what this means in easier terms is, what is the amount of time it is going to take for you guys to recover your investment? So payback period is total initial capital investment or total cash outflow, what I'm talking about, upon expected after tax net cash inflow. Expected after tax net cash inflow. And now you don't have to get confused, wait, what is all this, what is so difficult? No, just take into account whatever I'm getting, whatever is my cash inflow. Okay, just remember this word, cash inflow. This is very important, cash inflow. Okay, whatever cash I'm getting at the end of 1 year, whatever cash I'm getting at the end of second year, whatever cash I'm getting at the end of third year. Okay, for example, if I take an example, this example, suppose I have this example on my screen. I hope it is visible to everyone. And let me see if I can write on this as well. No, I cannot write on this. But I'll just, you know, explain. Please pay attention. Okay, suppose a project cost 20 lakhs. Okay, this is exactly the kind of question that is going to be given to you in the examination. And this is the exact question that we have talked about abhi recently. Okay, but there is one more additional thing that I want to discuss and then I'll end the lecture. Just one more thing, very small. Please pay attention. Suppose a project costs 20 lakh. The cost of the project is 20 lakh rupees. That is my initial outflow is 20 lakh. I can also write it down. Okay, never mind. Okay, the cost is 20 lakhs and the yield annually a profit of 3 lakh. And the annual profit is 3 lakh rupees. After depreciation, 12.5% at straight line method, but before tax of 50%. Before tax of 50%. So there's one more additional thing that you have to consider. After that, everything is done for and we don't have to worry about anything anymore. There is one more point that you have to pay attention to. I'll explain it. If my computer is going to support me, I don't know what is happening. I don't think it's going to work, but okay, understand. I cannot write, so please understand and listen to me. See, what is the meaning of depreciation? Depreciation is the charge of current of fixed asset on the annual. Like, you know, I'm dividing the cost of my current asset annually, assuming that that is the amount that I've used during the year. But the point that you have to pay attention to is cash. Depreciation is not paid in cash. And for the purpose of this capital budgeting, we are talking about cash flows. Okay, so there is a small adjustment that you will have to make every time that we are going to calculate cash flows. Okay, if in question the profit is given to you, like in this question, if you read, it yields annually a profit of rupees 3 lakh. If the profit is given to you in the question, that you have to make a small adjustment and go to cash flows. So from profit, you have to go on to cash flows. What is the actual cash flow during the year? How are you going to do is, dekhi, it yields an annual profit of rupees 3 lakh after depreciation. So profit is 3 lakh rupees after depreciation, but before taxation. So I'll pay tax. So my profit after tax is 1,50,000. Now I will add back depreciation. I'll add back depreciation. Why am I adding back depreciation? Because the amount of depreciation is important for payment of tax, but it is not actually paid to anyone. But depreciation is not paid to anyone, right? But depreciation is important to be deducted, because depreciation, like all other expenses, salary, rent, etc., depreciation is also an expense. Okay, because depreciation is also an expense, right? And I am going to get the benefit. I'm going to get the advantage of tax shield. My tax is going to reduce if I charge depreciation. Okay, is it clear? It is clear to you, right? And how I'm going to calculate depreciation? By the cost is 20 lakh. That is my cost. And the rate of depreciation at the rate is 12.5%. This comes out to be, you can calculate. This comes out to be 2,50,000. You can calculate this. Okay, so how I'm going to go from profits, if that is given to you in the question? If the question directly gives you cash flow, then you don't have to do anything. If profit is given to the question, then you have to go to the cash flow. And for that, you have to make just one adjustment. You just have to make one adjustment, that is of depreciation. You have to add back depreciation. So in the question, if the profit that is given to you is 3 lakh, okay, so this is how you're going to calculate. Profit that is given to you is 3 lakh. I'm not going to add back depreciation over here. Add depreciation, no. First, I will charge tax. First, I'll pay tax at the rate 50%. Okay. Then the profit after tax. In this amount, I will add back depreciation, because depreciation is not paid to anyone. And my annual cash inflow would be 4 lakh. Now I'll calculate payback period. That is very easy. Payback period is equal to cash outflow upon cash inflow. Okay, I'm going using very easy terms. So cash outflow, my cash outflow is 20 lakhs and my cash and inflow is 4 lakh. This gives me a payback period of 5 years. So in 5 years, I'm going to recover this 20 lakh rupees that I've invested. So this was all about payback period. And this is how it is solved. Okay, this is the 5 years payback period. And this is the second thing. When the annual cash inflows are not uniform, cumulative cash inflows are taken. For example, this is an example, and you can, we have already covered everything in the class. Okay, same. This is same exactly. Year, annual cash flow. See, cash flow is not equal. In that case, we are going to calculate cumulative cash inflows. Cumulative cash inflows. And this is how we are going to calculate the payback period. Okay. So you can go through all this once again. And if there is any problem in the to grasp at one go, like ek bar mein samajh aane thoda difficult ho sakta hai. Of course, I understand it. But please, you know, if there is any problem, you can definitely let me know. Ki sir, yahan pe problem hai, yahan pe samajh nahi aa raha. I will totally support you 100%. Okay, guys. Okay, everything is good. Okay then, I'm ending the lecture now. Please take care and have fun, guys.